On the other hand, had no father. And his mother?
I wish.
Well, she was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things.
You foolish child! What in heaven's name are you doing with a cow inside the house?
A warm environment might be just what Milky White needs to produce his milk.
It's a she!
Only she's can give milk.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them out again in 2 hours' time, then you shall go to the ball with us. And perhaps a snickerdoodle or four. Birds in the sky, birds in the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the castles and ponds. And a few of those birds. Down from the eaves and the leaves, out of fields, out of castles and ponds.
No squeeze, pal.
Quick little birds, into the ashes. Quick and pack, but swiftly sift through the ashes. Into the pot.
Listen well, Milky White must be taken to market.
Mother, no, he's the best cow in the whole world.
Was? She's been dry for a week. With no food and no money and no choice but to sell her while she can still command a price.
But Milky White is my best friend in the whole world.
Look at her. There are bugs on her duds. There are flies in her eyes. There's a lump on her rump, big enough to be a hump.
But,
son, we've no time to sit and dither. While her withers, wither, wither. And no one gives the cow for a friend.
Sometimes I fear he's a little touched.
I'm hoping to help the cow, so I won't be my bird. helped his mother and father in a baking accident. Well, at least that is what he believed. He was eager to have a family of his own, and was concerned that all efforts, until now, had failed. We have sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch next door.
We have no bread. Of course you have no bread!
To go to the festival, to the woods.
there.
Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor, and good fortune, like bad, can befall when least expected.
I wish.
Do you know what you wish? Are you certain what you wish is what you want? If you know what you want, then make a wish.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league east in the woods. Her house stands under three large oak trees.
East? But east is... Never mind.
I was heading towards market, but I seem to have lost my way.
And what are you planning on doing there?
Sell my cow, sir? No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? Where am I to get 5 pounds?
She must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
If you can't fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have enough food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans? We mustn't give up our beans. Well, if you feel we must.
Huh?
I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plate.
My dear.
Oh, but grandmother, what a big, terrible, wet mouth you have!
The better to eat you with!
Odd. Oh, where is that little one? Eating, no doubt. We're eating! Grandmother, what's that red cloth in the corner of your mouth? Seems to me to be a piece of the cape! Who cut it from within your stomach?
Me down a dark, slimy path where life's serious.
gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Aren't you the lucky one? Whatever are you doing in the wood at this hour?
Oh, where did she go?
Oh, no, please don't let them know here.
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her over there.
Oh, thank you. The prince were looking for me. I certainly wouldn't hide. And the prince, what was he like?
He's a very nice prince.
And?
It's a very nice ball.
And?
When I entered the trumpet of the prince.
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
And
it made a nice change
for the prince.
He has charm for a prince, I guess.
Yes?
I don't need a wide range. And it's all very strange.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow's eve?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? I would have been pursued by a prince. All that pursues me as far as bread. I wouldn't give another shoe. I need slippers.
Do you see that vine growing next to that cottage?
As pure as gold?
It looks like a beanstalk rising into the sky.
I need your shoe.
I must get home.
Oh, wait!
Come back here!
The fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a maiden. She lives here in the wood.
The wood?
Yes, at the top of a tall tower with no door or stairs. I stand beneath her tower and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climbed to her.
Rapunzel? Rapunzel! What kind of a name is that? You jest, brother, you jest.
I speak the truth.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain? is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. If there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torture they teach. What's as intriguing
or half so fatiguing
as what's out of reach?
Am I
agony that can cut like a knife? I must have her too.
You take plenty of spills, don't you?
Oh, it's these slippers. They're not much suited for these surroundings. And honestly, they're not suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers are as pure as gold.
Yes, they're quite beautiful.
Was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
And?
They have far too much food.
Well, the prince.
Yes, the prince. If he knew who I really was.
Ooh.
I'm afraid I was rude. Now I'm being pursued. And I'm not in the mood.
He must have really taken a liking to you.
Oh, yes, but I've no experiences with princes or castles and gowns.
Every girl dreams.
Look, sir, look!
Yes, there she is!
Where did he go?
A prince, of course.
Duh.
That direction. But you'll never reach them.
Wait, what if that mongrel with the cow had collected us?
Cow?
Yeah, cow, what do you think I said?
Please, let me compare this power with that.
Oh, no! Help you!
That's what I meant when they said
the
fragile leg. You should let me
perform
this poem with that of your own.
He wants to compare her to corn! Over there.
I thought you can too, but there's two of you. If I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us. As a pair of us, you accept it.
Children should listen.
No way!
What for you not to do, children must see.
No!
And learn. Why could you not obey?
And best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have. I have that lays golden eggs. The kingdom of the giant up there in the sky. And if you think that's something, you should see the golden harp the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes and you don't even have to touch it.
Okay.
Smeared with pitch, and there, when she left, remained the maiden's slipper.
Brilliant!
I thought so, though it did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
And sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the other slipper. Give them the slipper, and all will come to a happy end. Who are you, old man? At first tonight?
Illness.
He began his search for the foot to fit the slipper.
Darling, be still.
cut off a bit of the heel and it will. And wonder is why you have such a life. You'll never be to walk.
The girl obeyed, swallowing her pain. But as she was helped on the back of the horse by the steward, he noticed blood trickling from the shoe.
Have you no other daughters?
To which the woman replied,
No, only a stunted kitchen wench whom my late husband left behind. But she's far too dirty. She cannot show herself.
No, no, I insist.
Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper. It fit like a glove.
This is the true bride!
And much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, Cinderella joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his true bride.
No blood at all.
Wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell into his arms weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes, and their touch restored his vision. As is often the way in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her powers over others.
Just as long as you stay happy, we'll stay happy. of pen with my cow.
Little gurgle,
darling, I must go now.
We should really sell it.
Where's the cheesecloth?
We should, right?
I'm fine. You! Have you done this to our house?
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden.
What of your garden?
Look!
Destroyed.
Who could do such a thing?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
Must have been an earthquake.
No earthquake? My garden has been trampled.
Excuse me, madam. The small, unworthy peasant insists on seeing you.
Princess, I've come to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see it.
Then how do you know there's a giant in the land?
Well, there are footprints and my house is destroyed.
That could have been caused by any number of things. Now come along.
Wait!
A nearby household was visited by a giant not too long ago. It was descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember. That giant was slain, wasn't it? Now come along.
Wait, please. Princess, we have a young child, and he was very difficult to come by. His safety is of great importance to us.
Oh, what news have you? Oh, what of Mother's grave? Oh, but what am I to do? You know a princess is not supposed to go into the woods unescorted. Oh, but you're right. I can go see for myself if I just dress in my old clothes. Oh, thank you, birds.
Skies will change, the winds are strong. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
Into the woods to slay the giant.
Into the woods to shield the child.
To flee the winds.
To find the future.
And there's not much left of your house, either.
But I heard the giants never strike the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
Where's the lad who killed my husband?
There's no lad here.
We haven't seen him.
I want the lad who climbed the beanstalk.
We'll get him for you right away. Don't move.
It was you who destroyed our house. Not a great win. It's because of you I have no mother.
Sorry, I tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right. Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
That's my role. You must understand, there must always be someone on the outside.
You're on the inside now.
You're making a big mistake.
Nonsense.
You need an objective observer to pass the story along.
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
If you drive me into this mess, you'll never know how your story ends. You'll be lost.
Wait. He's right. He's the only one who knows how the story ends.
Do you think it will be fun when you have to tell it yourself? Think of your baby.
Stop. Let her go. She's right. Put down.
Now, that's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos. There must always be an outside server to tell.
Only I.
She must be gone to arrive before nightfall.
Where are you going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom.
We'll never make it there. We have to stay together if we want to make it out of this.
Your choice. How brave.
Brave?
Yes. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
This is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story. Wait, wait one moment, please.
What's wrong, ma'am? Do you have some service?
The tree is fallen. My mother's grave is destroyed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All my wishes have been crushed.
Oh, don't say that.
But it's true. You wouldn't understand.
Okay, well, you can't stay here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm certain the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
Well, there's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off seducing some young maiden.
What?
Well, I understand that's what princes do.
Not all princes.
You look like the princess, but dirty. You are the princess!
No, please get up. I'm not a princess here.
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
Oh, you haven't heard? The castle was set upon by the giant. The royal family was there.
And the prince?
He wasn't with them. No, come on. You shall be safe in our company.
What was that?
Was that me? Was that you? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me?
No more riddles, no more jests.
Stop the giant. Oh, you can do that? Oh, how can I ever thank you? Oh.
You can talk to birds.
Oh, the birds will help.
How so?
Well, when the giant returns, they can peck out her eyes and blind her.
What good will that do?
Well, then you can surprise her. Or strike her. Or whatever it is you do to kill a giant.
Right, then she'll stagger about.
She'll get angry.
Hello.
The giant went in that direction?
My darling? I didn't recognize you at first in these old clothes. And with a child. You must get back to the castle at once. There's a giant on the loose.
The giant has been to the castle.
No. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
My love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love, am I?
I love you, I do.
But yes, it's true.
If you love me, then why would you have strayed?
I thought if you were mine, I would be as content and as happy as I've ever been. And part of me is, but there remains a part of me that continually needs more.
I have, on occasion, wanted more, but that doesn't mean I went in search of it. If this is how you behave as a prince, what kind of king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I didn't ask to be born a prince, and I'm not perfect. I'm only human.
I think you should go.
Leave? But I do love you.
Consider I've been lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you really wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house, a dream. Now, I want something that's in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince.
I'd be very happy with these circumstances.
No one.
kayaks alone. Careful, no one is alone. People make mistakes. Fathers,
mothers,
people make mistakes. Holding to the
sad it is that she'll never know my son.